Good day, and welcome to a new discussion topic for EDUC 90, the teacher and the school curriculum. After achieving the necessary proficiency for the previous lessons, some of you had these questions running through your heads. The first one being, if that is the nature, scope, and definition of the curriculum, where do teachers situate in this seemingly comprehensive and complicated field? And the second one being, if those are the different types of curricula in school, what are the specific activities or actions that teachers do in relation to the different types of curricula? As I have said in the course orientation, as we move through this course, you will be able to understand the fundamentals of the curriculum theory and process. Hence, in this video, we will talk about the roles of the teacher as a curricularist. At the end of this lesson, you will be able to have 90% proficiency in A, determining the roles of the teacher as a curricularist in the classroom and in the school, and B, analyzing situations exemplifying the roles of the teacher as a curricularist. Before moving on to the multifaceted role of the teacher as a curricularist, let us define what the term curricularist means first. According to Hayes, Ornstein and Hunkins, and Hewitt, a curricularist is a professional whose specialization and expertise is the curriculum process. To elaborate, a curricularist is a person who understands and practices the curriculum principles and methods. They are also involved in the curriculum process. Now, you may ask, how does a teacher acquire roles that are similar to what a curriculum specialist does? Before I answer that, I want you to look at the words presented here and choose 5 words that you think could be both related to a teacher and the curriculum, using your knowledge of what a teacher does and your knowledge that you acquired from our 2 previous lessons. Pause the video and comment below the 5 words that you selected. After selecting 5 words that you think both relates to a teacher and the curriculum, I think that your mind has now made the connections between the two. So let us elaborate on that. In the school, teachers are asked to do tasks which are all guided by the principles of curriculum, instruction, teaching, learning, assessment, evaluation, and feedback. The classroom is actually considered as the first place of curriculum engagement. Thus, the interactions among the people inside a classroom or any environment, including the materials, as facilitated by the teacher, sets the standards and ultimately influences the teaching and learning process, eventually influencing schooling in general. Understanding how crucial the teacher is in the teaching-learning process could be supplemented by the knowledge of the different roles the teachers take on as a curricularist. Those 7 roles involve being a knower, a writer, a planner, an initiator, an innovator, an implementer, and an evaluator of the curriculum. Let us start with the teacher being a knower of the curriculum. One of the things that you should remember is that being a teacher requires you to be a lifelong learner. This does not only mean that you do not stop learning. Being a lifelong learner also means taking control of your own learning and becoming an independent learner aiming for personal development. What you are doing in our online classes right now gives you more control of your learning, so take it as a lesson and experience in practicing or developing lifelong learning skills in you. According to Bilbao and Dayagbil, in being a knower of the curriculum, the teacher starts with knowing about the curriculum as a content or subject matter, which is similar to what you are doing by studying your specialization courses. or what you call as your major courses or major subjects. Being a knower of the curriculum means acquiring academic knowledge, both formal and informal. Formal knowledge could be derived from disciplines and academic fields, while informal knowledge could be derived from experiences. Examples of formal learning could be studying further, like pursuing graduate degrees like master's degrees, PhD, etc., or attending seminars and workshops. One way to identify formal learning from informal learning is that formal learning is more structured, while informal learning is more flexible. Examples of informal learning could be divided into three: first-hand, vicarious or second-hand, and unintended. An example of a first-hand informal learning is when you are trying to study something on your own, like a hobby. An example of a second-hand or vicarious informal learning is when you have a friend who attended a seminar and talks to you about what she learned. Lastly, an example of an unintended informal learning is when you are browsing on a website for entertainment but you have acquired helpful information by chance. In this role of the teacher as a curricularist, Bilbao and Dayagbil identifies being a knower of the curriculum as having the mastery of the subject matter. The next role of the teacher as a curricularist is being a writer of the curriculum, which is actually one of the traditional tasks that is attributed to the job description of being a teacher. In this role, the teacher archives knowledge, concepts, subject matter, or content through writing, thus preserving them in books, modules, laboratory manuals, instructional guides, and reference materials, both in paper or via electronic media. This is the simplest one to digest or understand, since there is a clear application of the task, which is writing, and there are deliverables enumerated, which are the books, laboratory manuals, etc. The next role of the teacher as a curricularist is being a planner of the curriculum. The teacher as a planner of the curriculum analyzes the foundations of curriculum development, which are the philosophical basis, psychological explanations, historical developments, and societal demands and influences, and how each of these foundations of curriculum development should be integrated in the teaching learning process. You will learn more about the foundations of curriculum development in our succeeding lessons. After identifying how to integrate the foundations of curriculum development in the teaching learning process, the teacher has to make a yearly, monthly, or daily plan of the curriculum, which serves as guides in the implementation of the curriculum. The lesson plan itself is considered as the smallest unit that possesses all curricular elements, since the teacher takes into consideration several factors in planning it. These factors include the learners, the support material, time, subject matter or content, the desired learning outcomes, and the context of the learners, among others. Being an initiator of the curriculum is the next role of the teacher as a curricularist. For this role, remember that the curriculum is recommended to the schools by regulatory agencies like DepEd, CHED, and TESDA, by international bodies like UNESCO and UNICEF, and by other educational agencies, all for the improvement of the quality of education. In this case, the teacher is required to implement these recommended curricula for the first time, just like your teachers during the initiation of the K-12 curriculum in the Philippines. The implementation of a new curriculum requires open-mindedness from the teacher and the full belief that the curriculum will enhance learning. There will be many constraints and difficulties in doing things first or leading. However, a transformative teacher will never hesitate to try something novel and relevant. One of the hardest things to do is to adapt to changes, despite change being the only constant thing in the world. As an initiator of the curriculum, teachers must learn how to adapt to changes in the recommended curriculum as quickly as they can, since they are the ones who actually deliver the changes to the learners. The next role of the teacher as a curricularist is as an innovator of the curriculum. For this role, remember that the curriculum is dynamic as it changes depending on the needs of the time. From the content, strategies, ways of doing, blocks of time, ways of evaluating, kinds of students, and skills of teachers, one cannot find a single eternal curriculum that would perpetually fit. Before moving forward, watch this video of how Ngee-Ann Secondary School in Singapore was able to innovate their curriculum for the needs of the new types of learners. Pause this video, click on the URL on the description, or search for Singapore's 21st Century Teaching Strategies video by Edutopia. Since the new types of learners are more interested, engaged, and involved with the use of information and communication technology in learning, the teachers were asked to innovate their classes to integrate ICT in the classroom. In the role of the teacher as an innovator of the curriculum, remember that creativity and innovation are said to be hallmarks of an excellent teacher. A good teacher, therefore, innovates the curriculum. One concrete example of this that I could share on the classroom level was when I was a student teacher and there are activities in the recommended module of the DepEd that could not be done by my students due to their limited resources. I had to innovate what was in the module without changing the competencies and learning that they should acquire from the activity. To specify, instead of the students doing individual activities, there was a time when I just demonstrated the process and the learners observed, thus innovating the strategy for teaching and learning. I also had to adjust the activity sheets and guide questions in line with the new strategy, thus innovating the materials used. Next on the list is the teacher being an implementer of the curriculum. Just like a book, a curriculum that remains recommended or written will never serve its purpose. Somebody has to implement it. In the book analogy, someone has to read the book for the book to serve its purpose. In the teacher's role as a curriculum implementer, the teacher gives life to the curriculum plan. By implementing the curriculum with adequate and appropriate support, the teacher uses their facilitating skills in order to guide the learners to achieve the desired learning outcomes. By being an implementer of the curriculum, the teacher showcases teaching as a science and an art. As the interplay of all the elements of the curriculum form a combination of logical and creative and organized and flexible delivery. The success of a recommended, well-written, and planned curriculum depends on the implementation. The last one is the role of the teacher as an evaluator of the curriculum. This is where the teacher takes on the task of determining if the desired learning outcomes have been achieved, if the curriculum is working, if it brings desired results, if the outcomes reveal anything, if the learners are achieving, and if there are practices that should be modified, terminated, or continued. These are some questions that the teacher has to answer as an evaluator of the curriculum. It does not stop there, however. If it is observed that the curriculum is not satisfactory or if there are things that need to be modified in the process, the teacher gets the information or the feedback and uses it to revise and improve the curriculum. Basically, it is a trial and error, never-ending revision process. Well, those are the 7 different roles which a teacher does in the classroom every day, reflecting the work of a curricularist. To be a teacher means doing tasks that parallel those of a curricularist. Even if a teacher may not equal the likes of John Dewey, Ralph Tyler, Hilda Taba, or Franklin Bobbitt. You will learn more about these individuals throughout the course. A teacher will always be knowing, planning, writing, initiating, innovating, implementing, and evaluating the classrooms and the schools Just like the aforementioned forerunners and advocates in curriculum and curriculum development. To generalize the concepts you have learned in this lesson, let us go back to the graphic organizer introduced at the start of the discussion. What I want you to do is 1. To define in your own words each of the following roles of the teacher as a curricularist, and 2. Provide examples of each one. The examples could be anything that has happened to you or anything that you have observed or read about. Pause this video and try to do those 2 tasks. If you were able to do the 2 tasks that I assigned to you for the generalization part, it means that you were able to achieve the desired learning outcomes through the use of this video. Further assessment will be done later. Lastly, here are the references used for this discussion. We have the university recommended textbook and the supplementary readings that I sent through our learning management system. That would be all for today. Thank you and have a good day.